helping leaders motivate their people to a higher level of performance through strong human relations, team building, and goal achieving. This is the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast with your host, Paul Falavolito.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast, episode 162. And today I want to talk about why policies fail. As an EMS chief and creator of many policies that have failed over the years, I can certainly provide you with some insights on why policies may fail. Policies can fail for various reasons, and understanding these factors can help you avoid the same mistakes I made, identify potential pitfalls of your policy, and improve your chances of success. So here are some common reasons why policies fail. The first one is lack of clarity. So policies that are vague, ambiguous, or poorly communicated can lead to confusion and misunderstanding. It's essential to ensure that policies are clearly defined, easily understood, and effectively communicated to everyone involved. Number two is inadequate stakeholder involvement. So policies crafted without considering the input and perspectives of key stakeholders are more likely to face resistance and opposition. Engaging relevant parties early on in the policy development process increases the likelihood of successful implementation and adoption. And the neat tie-in to this point is just today on the FAA, the Federal Aviation Administration, social media, they put out an article talking about how these new air taxis are coming very, very soon. And they put out a call to the entire aviation community and all the pilots within the FAA system asking for their input on how they feel that these pilots should be credentialed. So it's very important to get your stakeholders involved early on instead of just coming out and saying, here's the policy, no ifs, ands, or buts, and no input required. It's going to be more successful the more people that you involve. So number three is unrealistic or unattainable goals. Setting unrealistic or unattainable goals within a policy can demotivate individuals or departments responsible for implementing it. Policies should be designed with a thorough understanding of the available resources, constraints, and capabilities to increase their chances of success. And number four is lack of accountability. So policies need a clear system of accountability to ensure that they are followed and enforced. And without appropriate mechanisms to track compliance and hold individuals or departments responsible, policies can easily fall by the wayside. Number five is inadequate resources. And again, policies often fail when there is insufficient allocation of resources such as funding, personnel, or technology required for the effective implementation. It's crucial to assess the resources requirements and secure the necessary support to ensure policy success. Number six, and this is usually the biggie, it's the resistance to change, because people naturally resist change. Your employees will resist change, and policies can disrupt established routines and workflows. Failures to address and manage resistance to change can hinder the policy implementation. And a comprehensive change management strategy that includes communication, training, and support can help overcome resistance. Seven is lack of flexibility. So this is policies that are too rigid and fail to accommodate changing circumstances or evolving needs are more likely to become obsolete. Building flexibility into policies allows for adaption and adjustments as necessary, increasing their longevity and effectiveness. And this is why you'll generally see a lot of policies with a lot of big companies come out that'll say, you know, 90 days from now, this goes into effect, because they want to give that 90-day buffer zone for everybody to get used to it. Number eight is inadequate monitoring and evaluation. So without ongoing monitoring and evaluation, it's challenging to gauge the effectiveness of policies and make necessary adjustments. we see this far too often that, you know, policy goes live and no one ever follows up on it. No one ever gauges it. No one ever measures it to see, is it actually working? So regularly assessing the policy's impact and collecting feedback can help identify areas for improvement and ensure its long-term success. Number nine, another biggie is lack of leadership and support. Because policies require strong leadership and support from management and other decision makers. When leaders do not actively champion the policy, provide guidance, and address the obstacles, its implementation can fail pretty quickly. And number 10, insufficient communication and training. Policies need clear and consistent communication to ensure understanding and buy-in from everyone. Additionally, providing adequate training and support to individuals responsible for implementing the policy can enhance its chances of success. So, by considering these factors and addressing them proactively, you can increase the likelihood of policy success. Remember that policies are not static, but should evolve and adapt as needed to meet changing circumstances and goals. Don't be discouraged if a policy of yours fails. People are not going to jump for joy at every policy that gets created. Don't take it personal and don't let it become a setback for you and your leadership. This has been the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast, and I thank you for listening.
For more Paul Falavolito podcasts, visit paulfalavolito.com.